Good morning, Vandan. Today we are going to discuss briefly about filter method for feature subset selection process. Earlier we have seen wrapper method for feature selection, feature subset selection. Let us try to recap the complexity or difficulty with that one. We started with exhaustive search over feature space. Exhaustive search means we will try to evaluate all possible subsets. Let's assume that we have x bar d cross 1, where for example d equal to 100. This is the original input feature vector. Now the number of possible feature subsets are, total number of possible feature subsets are 2 power d. 2 power d possibilities are there. If d equals to 100, that will be 2 power 100 possibilities. 2 power 100 we can try to write like 2 power 10 whole power 10. It's roughly 1024, right? Roughly 10 power 3 whole power 10 means 10 power 30. Approximately 10 power 30 possible feature subsets are there. Feature subsets. If the dimension of input feature vector is 100 cross 1, we need to evaluate total 10 power 30 possible feature subsets. It's very, very difficult, highly impossible to do this one, right? It's not easy to list all those subsets also. That's also very difficult, right? Forget about evaluation. Just listing itself is not so easy. 10 power 30 possibilities, so huge, right? In order to avoid this complexity, what we have done is we've gone for forward selection method and backward selection method. We followed greedy method, greedy approach for this. If you follow forward selection method, what we are doing is, first we'll try to try with all d possible features separately. We'll try to evaluate each and every feature separately, how they will contribute to classifier. Next, what we are doing is, we are freezing best one, best feature out of those d features, and you want to go with two features for the classification this time. Instead of one feature, you want to go for two features. One feature already freezed with the best one, then leftover features are d minus 1, right? We will try with the d minus 1 possibilities. And if you want to try with three features, you want to try with three features, then what we are going to do is, we will try to freeze two best features from this stage, right? From this stage, we'll try to freeze two best features. Let's have an example for this. What you have done is x1, x2, x3, x4. Let's assume that we have d equal to 4, four possible features. In the first stage, what you have done is, we have evaluated these four features separately, x1, x2, x3, x4, and let's assume that this is giving best result. Then what we are going to do is, we'll try to freeze this x2 in the second stage, and we'll try to evaluate for two features in this scenario. We'll try to freeze this, and we'll try to change this one, x1, this is x3, this is x4. Now, if at least one out of them is giving the best result as compared to this one, what we have done is, we are freezing that best result. Let's assume that this is the best result we got. And we are going to search for, after freezing that one, we are trying to search for one more feature by appending extra feature. We want to try with three features. Freeze x2, x3, freeze these two features, and we will try with remaining leftover features. Leftover feature in this case is x1 and x4, right? And if at least one of them is giving the best result as compared to this one, then we'll try to freeze that one. We'll try to freeze that. For example, if this is in the best result, we'll try to freeze this one. Now we'll try to add one more feature. One leftover feature for us is x1, right? The leftover feature for us is x1 after freezing these three. Now we'll try to evaluate the classifier with these features. If this is giving better result compared to this one, we'll try to give this as our final best possible subset, feature subset. If this is good compared to this one, we'll try to call it as a best subset. That's what we are going to do. Now we can try to see, right? In the stage 1, we are doing evaluation for D subsets. D equal to 4 here. 1, 2, 3, 4, right? In stage 2, we are evaluating for D minus 1 subsets. D minus 1 subsets, right? D minus 1 means 3. 4 minus 1, 3. 1, 2, 3. In third stage, D minus 2 subsets, right? D minus 2 subsets. Here D equals to 4. 4 minus 2 means 2 subsets. 1, 2. And final stage, D minus 3, right? D minus 3 is same as 1 here. 4 minus 3 equal to 1. This is D minus 3. This can be written as follows. If you want to generalize this one, D plus D minus 1 plus D minus 2, the number of possible feature subsets that we are trying to evaluate for our forward selection case. In the worst case, we can go up to this part. In the worst case, we'll try to go up to this final thing. We'll try to cover all possible features in the worst case. Best case means none of these two feature subsets is better as compared to this first x2 feature. Then you can terminate this one. You can terminate the search process. Then you can finalize this one as our best possible subset. Then no need to evaluate for them, right? You can evaluate only for two stages. Stage 1 with one feature, stage 2 with two features. After that you can remove, right? No need to compute this one. You can stop search here itself. That means in the best case, what we are going to get in the best case is, we'll try to end up with these evaluations only. 2D minus 1 evaluations. That's the best case. In the worst case, we can go up to covering all features, right? If we consider the worst case in forward feature subset selection process, then I am going to end up with the evaluation for these many number of classes. These many number of feature subsets are these many number of classifiers. Evaluation for all of them. Training plus evaluation together, cross-validation. And if I try to add all these, then I am going to get D into D plus 1 by 2 feature subsets, right? In the worst case. In the best case, I will end up with 2D minus 1 only. No need to go up to D into D plus 1 by 2 subsets also. Now, for example, D equal to 100. Then the number of possible subsets we are verifying or we are cross-validating in this process is 100 into 100 plus 1 means 101 by 2. Roughly, this is equals to 50 into 101. This is 5050. See, 5050, right? You can see this is far less compared to 10 power 30. 10 power 30 is with exhaustive search, right? You can see 2 power 100, all possible subsets, 10 power 30. 10 power 30 is much, much higher as compared to this one. It is much, much lower compared to this, right? This might be somewhat feasible. This might be somewhat feasible to do this one. But it also requires more number of computations because you need to train 5050 possible classifiers. After that, you need to cross-validate all those final classifiers. That required so much of time, right? Compared to this, this might be negligible. But still, this is not good enough, right? in order to avoid this, in order to reduce the compressions further, we are going for filter method. Instead of wrapper method, we are going for filter method. The filter method is as follows. Filter feature selection methods give heuristic but computationally much cheaper way of choosing a feature subset. The idea here is to compute some simple score S of xi that measures how informative each feature xi is about the class label y. Then we simply pick the k features with the largest scores S of xi. For example, we have already seen information, mutual information for knowing the feature relevance. For knowing feature relevance, we have seen mutual information measure or KL divergence measure, right? Here that KL divergence measure or mutual information measure can be taken as score S of xi. S of xi equals to I of xi comma y. Mutual information between ith feature and the output label y, output class label y. This can be written as KL divergence between p of xi comma y and p of xi into p of y. This will try to give feature relevance to our class labels, right? If that is highly relevant to our output, then we'll try to construct that feature for our classification purpose. If you feel that's not relevant for us, if that's not relevant for us means they are independent and this is almost zero, score will be almost zero. If they are not relevant, if that feature is not relevant to our class label, then this mutual information is almost nearby zero, then no need to construct that feature for our classification task. You can reduce the dimension in that way, right? Now we'll try to rank those features according to their scores in the decreasing order of scores. High score means that is good for classification. Less score means that is bad for classification task. And one standard way to select how many features for our classification, that K, that subset features, right? Number of features in the subset is represented by K. K will be in general much less than D. That's what our expectation. We want to reduce the dimension, right? We want to have K to be less than D. That's our target. And in order to figure out what should be the value of that K, we can take the help of cross validation. We will try to train a classifier and after that we will try to test on that classification model. If that is giving better result, then we'll construct that one. That's what our plan. And multivariate feature selection. In this slide, what we have done is univariate feature selection process. That is called as univariate feature selection process, where we looked at each feature independently of others, right? Because we computed the score of each and every feature separately. Is the score of ith feature, we will try to change this feature, right? S of x1 will compute, S of x2 will compute, up to S of xd will try to compute. We'll try to compute the score for all these d features separately, independently, right? That's what we had done. There is one more method, multivariate feature selection. Multivariate feature selection considers all features simultaneously at a time. Let us consider a two-class classification problem with training samples represented by x bar comma y, where x bar is d cross 1 dimensional feature vector. Let us try to classify them using linear decision boundary w transpose x plus w naught equal to 0. For example, with the help of a perceptron learning algorithm to learn the weights and biases. Then after, rank the features based on magnitude of the concerned weights. That is our plan for your multivariate feature selection. Let's try to have an example for this. What is our plan in multivariate feature selection is, let's assume that d equal to 5, for example, d equals to 5, x bar equals to x1, x2, up to x5. And the decision boundary we are going to have is w transpose x bar plus w naught equal to 0. This is the decision boundary we are going to have, which can be written as w1 x1 plus linear decision boundary, w2 x2 plus and so on plus w5 x5 plus w0 equal to 0. This is the linear decision boundary we are going to have. If you got greater than 0, we are going to classify it as class 1. If you got less than 0, then we will try to classify it as class 2 or omega 2. If this summation is above 0, we will classify it as class 1. If this summation or linear combination is less than 0, we will try to classify it as class 2. It's a linear decision boundary. The parameters are these weights and this bias will be learned during the learning process of our classifier. This is the model given to our system, and with the help of gradient descent algorithm and some loss function, somehow we got perceptron learning algorithm. Perceptron learning algorithm, this will try to calculate the parameters, suitable parameters or weights and biases. With the help of perceptron learning algorithm, we will try to learn these weights. Once you got these weights, we will try to fix those weights. And we can call it like a decision boundary. If you got greater than 0, that is classified as class 1. If you got less than 0, we are trying to classify it as class 2. That's what our plan. Suppose after training this model with the help of our training data, with the help of our training examples, somehow I got a decision boundary as follows. 50 into x1 plus 20 into x2 plus 110 into x3 minus x4 and plus 0.1 x5 plus 7 equal to 0. Finally, after training with my training data, I got this as my decision boundary. If I got greater than 0, I'll try to classify it as class 1. If I got less than 0, I'll try to classify it as class 2. Once I substitute my test samples x1t, x2t, x3t and so on, x5t, and if I got above 0, I'll try to classify it like class 1. If I got less than 0, I'll try to classify it as class 2. That's what my plan. In this case, I'll try to order them. I'll try to give the ranking for each and every feature. In this case, it seems that third feature is contributing more for the classification. You can see the weight of this one is 110, right? 110 is bigger than 50, the weight of this one, right? That's bigger than 20. In this case, this is W3, right? This is W1 and this is W2. And this is bigger than minus 1. But I'll consider only magnitude. No need to bother about sign. This is mod W3. I can call it like mod W2, mod W1, mod W3. And this is greater than 0.1, right? This 0.1 corresponds to mod W5. Okay, this is mod W4, right? This is mod W4. The weight of this one, weight of the fourth feature. I ranked them in the decreasing order of priority. In this case, third feature is having more weightage. X3 will have more weightage. After X3, more weightage is given to X1. After X1, more weightage will be given to X2. After X2, more weightage will be given to X4. After X4, more weightage is given to X5. Now, if you want to remove some of the features, it's better to remove from this point. This is having least priority, right? This is having least weightage. You can try to remove this feature. And you can consider this subset as our best possible subset. This is one way. If you want to remove one more feature, it's better to remove this feature. And if you want to remove one more feature, you can remove this feature also. Then this might be our subset. Best possible subset with two features. Like that you can think. This might be. In that way, you can think. It's a multivariate feature selection. And this is some variant of multivariate feature selection process. Recursive feature elimination. First, try to compute W bar on all features and remove features with smallest weights. After that, recompute W bar on reduced feature set. If stopping criteria is not met, then go to step 2. What we are doing here is, first we are training with all those features. Once we trained all those features, after training all these features, what I am doing is, I am trying to remove this fifth feature, because this is giving almost negligible contribution. It's negligible weightage as compared to others, right? This weightage is just 0.1, negligible, right? You can neglect this one. Now, try to train our classifier with the help of these four features, X1, X2, X3, X4. It means try to train this W1 X1 plus W2 X2 plus W3 X3 plus W4 X4 plus W0 equal to 0. Try to lengthen these parameters. We excluded that fifth term, right? Now try to train this with the help of perceptron learning algorithm and try to lengthen these weights once again. First of all, I got the weights as follows. After training, I got the weights as follows, minus 11, the other weights I got after training process. Then what I can do is, I'll try to arrange them once again in the descending order of magnitudes. In this case, once again, feature 3 is dominating. The magnitude of the weight is higher for this. Next dominating one is X1. Next dominating one is X2. Next dominating one is X4. Next dominating feature. Now, if I want to remove one of the features out of them, I can remove this fourth one. Now, I'll try to train my classifier with the help of these three features. And once again, you can repeat this process. That's what our plan here. Thank you.